So the topic is hubs, repeaters and bridges. All these devices are connecting devices. There are five types of connecting devices. The first type operates below physical layer. The second one operates at physical layer. The third type operates at physical and data link layers. The fourth type operates at physical, data link and network layers. And the fifth one operates at all five layers. Now hub operates below physical layer. The repeaters operate at physical layer and bridges operate at physical and data link layer. First one is hubs. Hubs are basically connecting devices. They are used as connectors in a network. The image shown in the slide is an example of hierarchy of hubs. It's a special feature of the hub because if the hubs are used in an hierarchy, the length limitation of 10 base T, that is of 100 meters, can be overcome. Now, they are used to make connections across network topologies like star. Unlike a network switch, a network hub has no routing tables, so it does not have any intelligence to where to send the information that it receives. So usually the hubs broadcast all the network data across each connection of a network. They can detect basic network errors like collisions, but sometimes they can also cause bottlenecks. Now there are two types of hubs, active and passive. Active hubs are basically multi-port repeaters. They are used in Ethernet applications. Passive hubs are connecting devices like connectors, and they are like a collision point of signals that come from different branches. The next one is repeaters. Repeaters usually mainly regenerate the signal that they receive, and they connect different parts of a network. Parts connected with a repeater are called segments of a network. The image in the slide is an example of such two segments connected with a repeater. Now, information carrying signals in a network can only travel a fixed amount of distance. After that, the attenuation occurs and the integrity of the data is affected. So we use repeaters to avoid such scenarios, because repeaters, they receive signal, regenerate it and send it forward. So this can be used to extend the physical length of a LAN. And the important point about a repeater is they can only be used inside a LAN network. They cannot be used to connect two different networks of different protocols. And so there's that. The repeater has a main function of regenerating, as I said, but it cannot be compared to an amplifier, because an amplifier doesn't have the discrimination. It cannot discriminate between signal and noise. It amplifies everything that it is fed, but repeaters are not like that. They regenerate the original signal. So as you can see in the image of the slide, the corrupted signals are fed to a repeater and the signal regenerates it, and the original fresh signal is forwarded again. The next is the repeaters. The location of a repeater in a network is very vital, because they have to be placed at distances such that the signal reaches the repeater before noise changes and the meaning of any of its bits. If it is late, then repeater cannot regenerate the signal, so the location is very vital. Next is bridges. Bridges can regenerate the signal and can also check the MAC addresses of the source and the destination. Bridges are different because they can decide if a frame that it receives should be forwarded or not, and if the frame is to be forwarded, then where. It has a table that maps the addresses to the ports. For this, it has filtering capability. Like I said, it can decide if a signal is to be forwarded or not. Now, in the image of the slide, it is an example of the bridge, that how a bridge works. Like, you can see two LAN networks, LAN 1 and LAN 2. So if a frame is destined for 712B1345.6142, and if it arrives at port 1, so according to the bridge table that is there, the frames destined for addresses like 7.1.2.B.1.3.4.5.6.1.4.2 are to be leaving from port 1. So because of this, the bridge drops the frame. But if a frame for 4.1 arrives at port 2, so according to the table, the frames for 4.1 are to be leaving from port 2. So it forwards the signal. Such is the working of a bridge. It can decide if a frame is to be dropped or a frame is to be forwarded. This is an example of just a two port bridge. In reality, bridges usually have multiple ports. And this is all about the three connecting devices that our topic had. Hope you understood, and thank you.